poor bastard's name was Claudio. I found out later he was a pretty big shot soccer player for the Galatians. Some nearly superstar just back from Europe. The usual. Scored goals, scored girls. The only box he'd be getting into now was the one he'd be leaving in. See the lobby on the other side. Time was a luxury I couldn't afford.
Hey, Sao Paulo's favorite bodyguard. How's it going, bro?
It's not good. Some guys took Giovanna and Fabiana.
What? Jesus, Max. Hey, I'm on my way.
No. Stay in the chopper. We'll need a way out of here. I'll go find the girls.
Got it. They came out there. They went that way into the lounge.
Come here.
Go.
Get up. You can't stay here. I need you to lock this door behind me. Get everybody else out of here.
Pop!
Son of a bitch. Son of a bitch.
Ah!
All this unfinished business, and all I could think about was my unfinished scotch. Much as I liked to indulge in self-reflection, this wasn't the time. It looked loud and expensive enough to be Fabiana's. Her fashion sense didn't leave a whole lot of room for imagination, let alone food. The girl sure knew how to draw the eye, and maybe that was the problem. But at least I was heading in the right direction. Whatever the hell they were arguing about, it was time for me to add my 2 cents. Victor's political campaign was starting to come unstuck. Seemed the Broncos' luck was on the turn. If only that was the worst news they'd received that day. They were still alive, at least. This crew was starting to look a lot like friends of the gatecrashers at last week's party. These guys had some real issues with the Broncos. They were back to finish the job. I figured it was time to start doing mine. This wasn't the time to be second-guessing.